talked and we had wonderful messages about how much we need the Holy Ghost in our midst. And I will tell you, I grew up in a church where it's the old church, God of Prophecy, in Freetown. And I remember as a child, I was about 8 or 9, but those members were filled with the Holy Ghost to the point where we're just learning or understanding now the operation of the gifts of the Spirit. But we had some sisters there. As soon as you walk through the door, they can tell you what's going on. And so, which tells us that we need the Holy Ghost now, because we got a lot of stuff going on. And if we don't have the Holy Ghost, I'm sorry, we're going to miss it. And it may try to overtake some of us. So I want to do an old-fashioned praise and worship memory. And I know I'm not the only one who was in an old-fashioned jumper church, because we all jumpers. I want you to get it.
Thank you. your weight on the presence of God.
I'm in the midst of our congregations if we can just give God worship. For his name is exalted above every name. And we need to come together like this. We need to come together and reach the Lord. Souls are dying. Men are dying every day in this country. And we need to reach the lost. And so this evening, I bring you greetings on behalf of our pastor, Bishop Carlton J. Stewart, and the leaders. We have Reverend Sanford Roll and Reverend Rufus Lightfoot joining us tonight. We thank God for them. And some of our other members should be here. But we bless God for the opportunity to worship together under the banner of Jesus Christ. There's a little song that we used to sing, and one of these days when we get to heaven, someone asked me the question one time I was walking through the streets, just witnessing to people. They asked, the little guy asked me, well, when you get to heaven, Ray, how are you going to know Jesus? And my mind quickly went back on the song, will be rewarded when we get inside the gate. Let's be encouraged. Let's stay on the wall and let's do what God has mandated us to do. God bless all of the pastors and the leaders from all of the various churches that are here tonight, and let us stay prayerful for the word of God.
time come, you outside.
what I say to us tonight. And thank you very much, Dr. Williams, our pastor, Main Street Church, and all those who got together, who God has placed into their heart to do this. Because we need more of this, so we could know how to behave. And other people will know that Christ lives in us. Because you see, it starts with us. If we can live inside so that others outside could see all those people different from us. So, God bless you, young. And do for God's sake wherever it started from. Let's continue. Let's continue.
Churches, God bless you and thank you for coming. It's offering time. It say a prayer. The offering. Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you thanks and praise for the gifts and the givers. We know, God, that you see the heart, the intent. And so we thank you for what these, your children, have given tonight. We pray that you will bless them, anoint them, give them more than their cups will be full and running over to give towards the spread of the gospel of Jesus Christ. We pray that you will bless their families, bless their homes, bless them in abundance. And more important, we ask that you live and reign in their hearts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. It's time now to hear what thus said the Lord. And our speaker for this evening is Reverend T.G. Morrison, Zion Baptist Church, East and Shirley Streets. He is an anointed man of God who preaches the gospel with strength, with power, and without compromise. And we thank God for his ministry because he is a blessing to the body of Christ. He is a blessing to the entire nation as we all look forward to those Sunday morning services as we get the message from Zion. I think they refer to the church on East and Shirley Street. No. So we give God thanks for all that he